Hey guys, welcome to the part 3 on Dell Storage 20. Guys, I'm first of all, I would like to clarify a few things here. I'm not going to give you an expert knowledge on Dell Storage 20 here. Even I'm in a learning curve for Dell Storage. I would like to share whatever I learned. So please don't give me any negative marks on the training. I'm trying my best to learn with you guys and at the same time try to share what I'm trying to learn. So it's like a collaborative experience. I'm trying to learn and share whatever I'm doing, and hopefully people will enjoy it and experience it in the next level. So guys, enough of explanation. We have done creating the live volume using the plugin, Dell Storage plugin. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a live volume out of it. So when you create a data store, it's not a live volume, right? It's just a data store with the VMFS file system on it. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to create a file, a live volume on it. So let's explore where is our data store. So just click on this data stores here. There we go. Here is our data store, Sandeep dash data store 1. So let's go double click on that. Go to Dell Storage Actions. Here we can basically resize or remove this particular data store, or you can do replace. Replace is something you can create a replay in the sense. Replay is like a snapshot for this data store. So we already created one replay schedule for this. It's using the default schedule for this. So what we're going to do right now is click on replication slash live volume. Click on add. So here we're going to select the another storage center, 3902. Click next. Basically, this data store which we created was hosted on 900. So what we are going to do is we are doing it on 902. So we're selecting the 902, and it's going to give the replication options here. We need to select live, whether it is synchronous or asynchronous. What we're going to do is we're going to sync, do synchronous live volume, high availability. And folder location will be LV. This is the QoS definition actually. You can define the QoS policies in the Dell Storage Manager, Enterprise Manager. So this is the QoS policy which we have. And it's going to duplicate the source folder path at the destination. So it's not going to do any overwrites. It's just going to duplicate. So we're going to click next. It's the same. We don't have any other live volume settings with the secondary QoS definition. As you can actually go to the advanced here. If you have a secondary QoS definition, you can actually go to the advanced and select the different options here. For example, you want to manage the bandwidth and all these things, you can select all those options there. So secondary mapping will be for the site A. Click next. So this is a summary of the live volume that we are going to create. Click next, finish. So guys, we created the live volume for this particular data store. This process will convert the what we created as a traditional data store to a synchronous live volume replication in high availability mode. So if you remember, we selected that the live volume replication in high availability mode, or you can also do live volume asynchronous replication in high availability mode, or the different other options there, you remember, right? So you can do that. So the vSphere client should take approximately 1 to 2 minutes to complete the task, and it can be monitored in the recent tabs poster here. Just a minute guys, where is the task panel here? So it's executing the Dell Storage task here, which is 40% complete. Just give it a few minutes to complete it. Thank you. So after completing this, what we'll be doing is we'll be enabling the auto failover on the live volume. That is, if you don't do that, it will not be enabling the high availability. So go to the storage client or the enterprise manager. Click on replications and live volumes. So this is the replications and live volumes tab that we have, and we click on the live volumes. So guys, the live volume that which we created on the vSphere web client is being shown on the enterprise manager. So we can see the details here, like the primary volume is Sandeep dash data store 1, and the secondary volume will be LV of live volume of Sandeep underscore data store 1. Guys, basically what you can do is you can pause this thing, you can force delete it, you can do a lot of things. You can put a save restore point on that particular volume. We'll do that. Alright. Now you can go to the restore points and see the restore point is there. So basically using this restore point, you can do the recovery process. So basically I click on and I can validate it, or I can restore or restart a DR volume. I can do this, click next. I'm sorry, I did not select this storage center pair. That we'll explore it later. So we can validate the restore points and everything. So let's go to the live volumes. We see the volume up and down. The primary status is up and secondary status is up. You can pause, you can revert to the replication, you can edit the settings. What I want to do is basically I want to edit the name of the secondary volume. You can change the settings here also, the type and the sync mode. The deduplication will be enabled or disabled, you can do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to enable the failover automatically. That's a good option so that we can test it now. Click OK. Now guys, that's what we did is right now we created the live volume and we enabled the automatic failover setting for this. One more thing I want to do actually is to rename the secondary volume. Let's do it. My question is, will we be able to do that? I think yes. Let's put 95. Sandeep data store 1. I'm not sure guys, but it applied the policy here. We can go to the replications and live volumes, just refresh. Yeah, we got that right. So basically guys, for example, if you want to manage these volumes in particular, you need to go to the storage here and manage the volumes directly on the storage center here directly. Click on storage and you see the live volumes here. You can do that. And you can manage the servers also from here. Different servers and the fault domains. Fault domain is something where you want to do a domain level disaster recovery. There you can create fault domains and you can do it from one domain to another domain. The disks, the storage types, policies, everything. We're going to explore all these things basically. So the hardware settings here, the I/O usage, the charting, the alerts, the logs. So guys, basically when we want to explore what are the controllers that we are using, this is the hardware information. Basically, we are using this particular thing. the model number and all. I'm just exploring few details here. Guys, again, I'm telling you, this is all Dell compliant storage. We did not even start with the Ecologic, which is the SAN. This is completely the NAS setting, the NAS feature from Dell. So that's it, guys. It's giving very good granular information on different things like the power supply, I/O modules, cooling fans, audible alarms. I'm going to test each and every one of this, and then I can say, you know, I know Dell storage. So I'm going to do each and every one. I may not be able to record that in the labs because of the time constraint that we have, but I'll be testing each and everything. And for example, if you guys have any doubts on the particular things which we do, definitely you can contact me and I'll be able to assist you with that. So guys, that is the granularity that you can you can create a thing from here also, the set volume profiles, the replay profiles, and map the volume to a particular server. That's really good. The remove mappings option. So guys, this is it, and in the next lab, what I'll be trying to do is vSphere Metro cluster configuration and the failover. Thank you very much for watching this lab. Have a nice day.